the mask of Inanna.
Oncoming lane of traffic, but he takes the wheel in time to gain control again. What little control he has.
Those bushes ahead. If I can swerve into them from the side, they'll slow me down.
He struggles with the gears, shifting down to second as the engine moans, grinds, and chews itself. With the edge of the hill approaching fast, he turns right, then left. Wheels screech as the car spins sideways into the bramble. It bumps once, twice, three times as it tears through the bushes. The lights beneath it are close. It can go over any second now. A back wheel slips and spins out over the open air. Then he sees the glint beside him. Too late! It's the black and white paint of a police car waiting in the bushes at this dangerous curve. Glass shatters as he hits the cruiser. Wheels spin in the mud as Abe is thrown about, but his car stops just in time as the police cruiser totters over the edge. Abe breathes and tries to compose himself as the police car topples and falls down, down into the ravine. The explosion illuminates the world below.
I'm alive. I'm alive. It's over. Oh, but what of the policemen? Poor souls. I better hitch a ride to the hospital. Ah, at least my door opens without a hitch. Wait a minute. This side of the car is fine. Yeah, let me check. The side that hit, it's beaten in, but I've seen worse come into our body shop. Ha! Can you imagine that? That prototype must have been a clunker. The cars in our showroom are fine. And me. I'm fine. Oh, thank heavens. Thank heavens!
Abe's luck stays with him. A passing driver stops for aid and takes him straight to the hospital. The orderly tells him he's fortunate to get away with only a few sprains. Abe's wife, Sarah, arrives to pick him up.
Oh, Abe, from what they said on the phone, I thought you'd be in such a state.
Don't make a fuss over me. I'm fit as a fiddle.
Let me see. I've been so worried. I could hardly drive straight myself.
I'm gonna be okay, dear. I'm gonna last to 100.
You'll stay off the bottle from now on.
Darling, the bottle had nothing to do with this.
If you say so. Come on, the car's out front.
The two of them stop by the police station to file a report.
You'll probably want to charge me with manslaughter, officer. I freely admit the car was out of my control, but it's gotta be worth a few years off my sentence if I cooperate.
I don't think so, Mr. Evans. We keep a police car at that turn to encourage motorists to slow down, but there's never anyone inside it.
What? Oh, that's wonderful news! Did it hit anyone?
No, Mr. Evans. The car got caught in the trees below and never made it to the residences.
That's fantastic! Fantastic!
The next day, Abe does return to work a changed man. He goes straight to his boss's office. He's rarely had to use his silver tongue there, but today, he'll need it.
Charlie, I don't know if you heard from the repair shop yet.
Yes, I did. I'm sorry about the accident. Why don't you take today off? Steady your nerves.
Look, have them check the Tercel Coupe for tampering. The line was cut. It was filed down so it would snap when I hit the brakes hard. It wasn't my fault. I'm pressing charges as soon as we have the evidence.
That won't be necessary.
Why not?
There won't be a police report. I've squared it away with the boys downtown. The papers will report it as a hit and run. tomorrow, you'll be back on the show floor selling my cars.
Really? You mean it?
Yes.
Oh, I'll be selling them, Charlie. You better believe it. The next couple that comes in with any trumped-up article, I'll tell them what really happens. Even a wet road and a side impact couldn't stop this car.
Excellent. And I'll have the Tercel Coupe back on the showroom floor by then.
What?
This isn't the first time they've had to repair it. But with you, hopefully it'll be the last. Ask yourself, how have your co-workers managed to sell my car so well with a fraction of your experience?
Well, I'll just be going then.
See you later, Abe.
I'm not sure if I want to go to Margaret's today. Then again, I'll finally have her in my back pocket. Maybe for a long time to come.
Abe walks off to find his old car in his old parking spot. On the way to his girlfriend's apartment, he begins to calculate how much he can get for a trade-in on a new vehicle. Then again, his old car has come through for him when he's really needed it. He could buy a new one and keep the old one around for sentimental reasons. Back in the office, the boss Charlie sits and smiles at what he's done. He knows there is no better a salesman, no matter how slick he is, than one who truly believes in his product. All it takes is a personal demonstration and a snip to a brake line.
So it ends, my friends, and the world grows a little darker. Who really cut the brakes in Abe's car? Wasn't it fortuitous that the empty police car was waiting in those bushes? Could it be, perhaps, that the report of his cars being unsafe was correct, and that Charlie gave Abe a rigged, safer car to encourage him to sell a bad product? I don't know about you, but after tonight's tale, I wouldn't be caught dead out after dark.
After Dark, brought to you each week on this station by the makers of Winsley Wheat, features Leonard Allen, Isabel Huddleston, Matt Lerner, and Robert Stroud. After Dark is written by Matt Lerner and is produced and directed by Leonard Allen. Our special guest this week was Mr. Edward Winsley himself as the narrator. Tune in next week for another tale of mystery and fright right here on
After Dark.
And we're clear.
Well, that was exciting. Thank you all for indulging me.
Ed, you've got a voice that would outpurr a kitten. You come back anytime, I mean it.
You want a job with me, too.
I'm taken, but thanks.
You're welcome. And don't worry. You keep with these scripts, Winsley Wheat is going to love After Dark forever. Keep up the good work, everyone.
Thanks, bye. Oh, Inanna. Hey, Art, love the Foley. Whatever you put that ice in, save me some of it.
Len, I had another call from Price. He loved last week's show.
Great job, Len.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You're all a bunch of pussycats, you know that?
Hear, hear.
What would you say about me if I didn't have your checks?
Ah!
Save it for next week. I got them right here.
All right. Who wants to go get sloppy at Johnny's?
Let me see that. Len, you rounded down again, I see.
That was Bob, not me.
Yeah, you're lucky you got anything this week.
Let me see yours.
Sure, you want the bill for the studio equipment, too?
Yeah, you can give it to me.
Everybody, settle down. Rehearsal's Tuesday. Be on time.
If I was on time, you wouldn't appreciate me so much.
We might appreciate you a little more. Anyway, Matt. Where's Matt?
Just left. Beating us to Johnny's.
Remind him that I need those scripts tomorrow.
You bet.
I'm serious.
I know.
All right, get out of here. Good night.
Night, Len. My kid sends her love.
Hey, bring her by sometime.
Hey, Len.
Yeah, Bob?
Can we talk for a bit?
Sure. What can I do you for?
Are you going to Johnny's later?
I might be.
We might as well get started now. Got a bottle right here.
Oh, what's the occasion?
We haven't had a chance to talk in a while. This is the finest bourbon I could find. It's my favorite. And yours.
Is there a toast to go with it?
All right. To the stations that run your show. Your gorgeous Gwen, who keeps you steady. To our fine town, who knows the color of our skivvies. And to Isabel, Matt, and the rest, who have kept our noses to the grindstone.
It's a good grindstone, though. See, we picked up two more stations this week, and we're 7 away from 100 episodes.
That's a good man, isn't he?
He sure is. He's a lush, but he can read him as well as he can write him.
I mean, he's holding us back. You and me.
Are we talking about the same Matt here? He brings the scripts. He brings his voice. He doesn't run squat. We do.
What if NBC came in today, right now, and made you an offer on the show?
I'd tell them where they could go unless they took all of us. Matt, too. Every channel, they've got a mystery or a horror show, but none of them has Matt. Or Isabel. Or me, or you.
Come on. I'm a hack. I'm as bad as Peter Lorre. Matt should be doing my part.
Matt can do your voice when you're gone. Besides, look at that. That's how much we have left in the reserve. Thanks to you.
You're a sweet talker. You get another drink. But you get my point. You and I could be doing a lot better.
If you suddenly have a problem with Matt, you tell me. I'll make it right. That's why you hired me, isn't it?
I'm leaving the company. I'm going west.
Then how am I going to get the books done?
I have the number of an excellent accountant.
I don't want an excellent accountant near this money. I want you.
C'est la vie.
No, this is your money. It's always had your fingerprints on it.
Right. Because we've been doing this for the money.
I know you're paying the electrician to keep the equipment running here. If you go, what am I supposed to do? Slip him a 10 out of the blue like it just occurred to me?
Have another drink.
Damn it, man! Why have you been stringing me on as long as you have?
I can't keep on doing this in this little Pennsylvanian Hicks town forever.
Oh, you're just doing this to break my heart. And look, a $5 bottle of bourbon earned you the generous soul. Here's your hat. What's your hurry?
You need to punch something? How about here on my big fat jaw? Go right on ahead.
Bob, I'm getting drunk. I need to be sober to hit you proper.
There we go, see? All is forgiven over spirits.
I know when I'm beat. Why tonight? Why me? Why not in front of everyone?
They'd kill me. They'd string me up six ways to Sunday.
Please, what'd you ever do to them?
Well, you finished most of the bottle, so I guess I can tell you.
Yes, please tell me why you're running off and leaving me with twice the work. I bet it's for a woman.
I'm gonna go join up with the shepherd.
When did you find religion? Or did you try out some religion and it won't go all the way with you?
Something like that.
Well, what's her name?
There isn't a her. There isn't a him. There's big plans, and I'm going to try and be a part of them while you're stuck here in the thrall of the Wild Maiden, getting played by Matt, Isabel, and everyone. You can't see beyond the end of your own nose.
I'm gonna tell Gwen you called her that.
She isn't the Wild Maiden. You're in the center of it all, and you never even guessed?
What?
They need your show.
Nobody needs our show. Now you don't need it. I don't know what you need.
I need to make it big. I've got a chance, and who knows when I'll get one again.
What am I gonna tell the others?
Tell them that I'm going to join the Shepherd. They'll have figured it out already.
Besides that?
Tell them that I'm a no-good son of a gun and that their kids will have to stand on their own two feet.
You can't wait one more week. I won't say anything.
You know I can't.
Fine. You better write me.
You know I will.
You're not making sense at all. We've been doing this show since 52. Are you gonna be here when I sober up so I can give you that smack?
Give my love to Gwen, won't you?
No, you tell her yourself. When you come back.
Yeah, you should get going. They'll be waiting for you at Johnny's.
I'll clean up. You go. Wait. Give me a check.
Here, that ought to hold you. See you.
Check the presto on your way out. Make sure Art actually turned the thing off this time.
Not my job anymore, Len. You take care of yourself and all your Wild Maiden buddies.
You too. I don't know how I'll do this show without you.
You won't.
From Hollywood, USA, Old Maggie Mopheads presents Master Stroud's Grimoire of Horror. All the tales you fear the most. Hungry goblins, scary ghosts. Broadcasting from coast to coast.
Len, the scripts! I've checked everywhere. They're all gone, Len.
We take you now, live, to my mansion, where the most fiendish villains roam the dusty halls.
That son of a weasel. He stole them.
Tonight, we continue a tale most foul. It's called, And by the Break Light's Red Glare.
We've still got the recordings. We can get them back on the air.
How? Have you read these letters? All these new stations picking up Bob's show? There's too much money behind him.
Give it some time. Have a little patience. We can find new stations. A new sponsor.
No. That's it. I can't do this.
Please. I'm sure Matt has copies of the scripts.
You don't understand. You see this stack of letters? They're from the stations who won't renew our contract. They want to play his show. We're off the air.